The Christmas Day News now on BBC One Wales with Shaun Ley.
Hello. The Prince of Wales and the Duchess of Cornwall have led members of the royal family to church at St George's Chapel in Windsor Castle this morning. The Queen did not attend the traditional Christmas service, a precaution due to the rise in COVID cases. She'll be spending the day at Windsor with Prince Charles, Camilla and other members of her family. The Queen's speech, broadcast later today, is expected to be a personal reflection on a difficult year following the death of her husband, Prince Philip. Nicholas Whittle reports.
Morning service at Windsor Castle. Members of the royal family, though not the Queen, joined the congregation at St George's Chapel.
Happy Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
The royal party was led by the Prince of Wales and the Duchess of Cornwall, who arrived on foot. The Queen's Christmas broadcast at 3 o'clock this afternoon will be an unusually personal one. She's expected to reflect on the death of her husband, Prince Philip, earlier this year. In his Christmas message from Canterbury Cathedral, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Justin Welby, reflected on the impact of the pandemic.
We all face uncertainty, uncontrollability and unpredictability. Whether we are working in SAGE or the Cabinet, to each one of us, from huge companies to those who are sleeping rough.
At the Vatican, Pope Francis spoke about the importance of dialogue. He urged world leaders to engage with each other to solve problems and prevent conflicts. Nicholas Whittle, BBC News.
Volunteers are working at vaccination centres across England today as the push continues to give every adult a booster by the end of the month. The NHS says it expects thousands of people to receive their jab on Christmas Day. Vaccination centres are closed in Northern Ireland, Scotland and Wales. As ministers consider whether tougher restrictions are needed in England, the Roman Catholic Archbishop Cardinal Vincent Nichols has urged them not to close places of worship. Emily Unier reports.
Redbridge Town Hall in East London is one of a small number of vaccination centres in England that opened this morning on Christmas Day to help bolster the booster programme.
Fantastic idea to come to save so many lives.
My job, I'm in contact with customers all the time. I've got to keep myself safe, keep my customers safe.
The crux of it is it's family time. It's time that you want to spend with your loved ones. And it's often times like that that we get to think through the real priorities. And the real priorities are that you want to protect yourself and you want to protect your loved ones.
The government wants to offer all adults a booster by the end of the year to tackle the spread of the Omicron variant.
This pharmacy here in North London has been open since 8 this morning. They've got about 80 appointments pre-booked, but there's capacity for at least another 400 people to just walk in off the street and get a jab.
And there was a very personal reason for opening over the Christmas break.
I'm very close to the owners of this shop, the original owner, Nilesh Patel. He actually passed away from COVID January this year. And it was a horrible experience for his family and the sons, Mitten and Nicket, to go through. And they have been working very hard, as have I, to make sure that no one else goes through the same thing as they did.
This new variant appears to cause milder illness, which health officials have described as a glimmer of hope. It's still spreading fast, though, prompting Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland to introduce new restrictions. In his Christmas message, the head of the Catholic Church in England called on the government to keep places of worship open.
I think we're at that point of saying we understand the risks, we know what we should do, most people are sensible and cautious. We don't need stronger impositions to teach us what to do, we know.
New restrictions for England, known as Step 2, could see pubs and restaurants serving customers outdoors only, and a ban on different households mixing indoors. A decision on whether to bring England in line with the other UK nations could be taken early next week. Emily Unia, BBC News.
One of the greatest scientific missions of modern times has taken a giant leap forward in the last hour with the launch of the James Webb Space Telescope. The $10 billion project has taken 30 years to reach this moment. The telescope was launched from Kourou in French Guiana. It's the most powerful ever built, and the developers hope it will reveal stars and galaxies from the birth of the universe, as well as distant planets which could provide evidence of life beyond Earth. Our science correspondent Rebecca Morell reports.
And we have engine start. And liftoff.
The start of a blockbuster astronomy mission.
James Webb begins a voyage back to the birth of the universe.
Inside this rocket is the biggest telescope ever sent into space.
Punching a hole through the clouds, 20 seconds into the flight.
This is the James Webb Space Telescope. It's a successor to Hubble, but 100 times more powerful. After 3 decades in the making and a cost of $10 billion, it's finally on its way.
We've never attempted anything like that in space before. We're going to be entering a whole new regime of astrophysics, a new frontier. And that is what gets so many of us excited about James Webb Space Telescope.
This space telescope is a feat of engineering. At its heart is a 6.5 meter wide mirror made up of 18 hexagonal segments, each coated in a layer of gold. Its size means it can detect the incredibly faint light coming from the most distant stars. It also has a huge sun shield about the size of a tennis court. It's made up of 5 layers, each as thin as a human hair. And this protects the telescope from the heat and light of the sun.
Sitting 1 million miles away from the Earth, the telescope will give us our deepest ever view of the cosmos, from seeing the birth of the very first stars and galaxies to revealing new planets in far-flung solar systems.
What excites me is making discoveries, things we haven't thought about. And there's a whole history of astronomy that shows how, when we've looked at the new universe in a new way, we discover things we hadn't thought about, and there's something really exciting about doing that.
To get into space, the telescope's so big it's been folded up to fit inside the rocket. The most challenging part is getting it to unfurl. It's been practiced here on Earth, and that's hard enough. There are 300 points where it could go wrong. But if anything fails in space, the telescope is too far away to be fixed.
Separation Webb Space Telescope, go Webb!
This is the most ambitious space telescope ever built. Now its mission has finally begun, and our view of the universe is about to be transformed. Rebecca Morell, BBC News.
Finally, if you're dreaming of a white Christmas, you need to be in Scotland or the Yorkshire Dales. This is how things are looking in Braemar and Aboyne in Aberdeenshire. Perthshire, the Shetlands and parts of Yorkshire are also enjoying festive weather. For the rest of us, it's something more traditional. Rain. That's it from the newsroom for now. The Queen's speech is on BBC One at 3 o'clock. The next news on BBC One is at 10 to midnight. Enjoy the rest of your day.